Mycobacterium Leprae. Mother Teresa is the person who served the leprosy patients in India for many years, and she got the Nobel Prize. Mycobacterium Leprae. These are weakly gram-positive organisms. They are acid-fast bacilli, and they can cause the infection called leprosy in humans. And this leprosy infection can be referred as Hansen's disease, and these organisms are referred as Hansen's bacilli. And these are aerobic, non-motile, non-spore-forming organisms, and these are obligate intracellular parasites. They won't grow in artificial medium, they always grow in host cells. And these organisms infect peripheral neurons. Whenever they infect peripheral neurons, especially Schwann cells, that can lead to ultimately peripheral neuritis, and we can see anesthetic lesions, loss of sensation in that areas. And these organisms can also infect skin and mucous membranes. And these organisms have a similar cell wall, same like Mycobacterium tubercular organisms. And in Mycobacterium tubercular organism, they will have one variety of lipid called mycocytes. Instead of this mycocytes in Mycobacterium leprae, they will have phenylglycolipid 1. Mycobacterium leprae will have phenylglycolipid 1 in their cell wall. And the remaining structure of the cell wall of Mycobacterium leprae is similar as Mycobacterium tuberculosis organism. These organisms will grow in food pads of mouse and armadillo animals, and we can see these organisms in armadillos, especially in US, in Texas regions. Epidemiology. There are two varieties of leprosy infections. One is tuberculoid leprosy, and in this tuberculoid leprosy, the patients who are suffering with this infection, they can't transmit this infection, they won't transmit this infection to the other people. Whereas leptomatous leprosy, the next variety of infection, always these patients with leptomatous leprosy, they always can transmit this infection through respiratory route by a droplet form. Tattoos, the needles which are used in tattoos can also one of the major transmitting factor in humans. The incubation period is in between 2 to 7 years, prolonged incubation period, and normally seen these infections in Asian countries, higher incidence in Asian countries, and in North America very few cases. And we can see this organisms in armadillos, especially in Texas and Louisiana regions. People who are close contact with armadillos animals in Texas regions are highly susceptible for this infection in US, North American regions. Pathogenesis. There is no known pathogenesis. Whatever we are discussing in this lecture is just a hypothesis. These organisms can infect macrophages and Schwann cells, and they can replicate inside these macrophages and Schwann cells by inhibiting phagosome-lysosomal interaction. And whenever they infect Schwann cells, we can see anesthetic lesions. In tuberculoid leprosy, we can see granuloma formations. We can see tubercles. That's why it is tuberculoid leprosy. We can see granulomas, which are called as tubercles. And these tubercles are in response with cell-mediated immunity, that is delayed hypersensitivity reaction. And because of this granuloma formation around these infected cells by these organisms, and these granulomas pour their enzymes, and ultimately these organisms will die. And you can't see any organisms inside the granulomas in tuberculoid leprosy patients. So these granulomas, which are formed against Schwann cells, adjacent to the infected Schwann cells, we can see nerve enlargement in that area, and because of macrophage pouring of enzymes by macrophage onto this Schwann cells and nearby neurons, we can see the damage of peripheral neurons, and we can see loss of sensation, and we can see peripheral neuritis whenever these organisms are infecting Schwann cells. Anesthetic lesions. In leptomatous leprosy, majority of the patient will have cell-mediated immune deficiency. They won't have a very good cell-mediated immune response. So many organisms we can see in the lesions of leptomatous leprosy, tissues, peripheral neurons, and overgrowth of bacteria in cells can ultimately damage the tissues, and because of damaged tissues we can see a loss of digits, loss of nasal septum, loss of testis, and the patient will have disfigurement. Clinical features. Tuberculoid leprosy, we can see macules which are flattened, pale in nature. Normally we can see these macules in limbs, face and trunk, and these macules will have raised edges and they are dry in nature with loss of hair. There is no hair on these lesions. And macules with longer duration without sensation, we must diagnose or we must check for tuberculoid leprosy infections. And slow progressive healing whenever the patient is having good cell mediated immunity. And after defense mechanism, if the patient is having good cell mediated immune response, we can start to see granulomas in these patients, and these organisms will be destroyed inside these granulomas. You can see only granuloma cells but no organisms inside these granulomas in tuberculoid leprosy patient, because they will have a very good cell mediated immune response. That's why these infections won't spread and you can't see a very severe lesions in these patients. And this is tuberculoid leprosy pictures, and these are the macules with raised edges. These are the macules with raised edges, dryness, and there is no hair. And this is the macule. Leptomatous leprosy. In these patients, the cell-mediated immune response is absent, so you can't see any granuloma formations in these patients. But these patients will always have a good humoral immune response. We can see infiltration deep into tissues, in even into the bloodstream, and lesions are extensive, diffuse on face, and we can see the thickening of skin on face, especially in the frontalis muscle areas, and cheek areas, chin areas, and on the ear auricle regions. We can see the thickening of skin, and in some patient we can see a loss of nasal septum and digits. So altogether, because of thickening of skin on the face, always gives an appearance of line-like face to these patients. And in some cases we can see testicular atrophy, loss of digits, loss of nasal septum, which will always give a social stigma to these patients. And this is the thickening of skin on the face and loss of nasal septum, thickening of skin above the frontalis muscles, and this is the loss of digits in the foot, and this is the hand, loss of digits. And whenever we scrape these areas, if you stain the scraping of these lesioned areas, we can see lot of organisms in leptomatous leprosy patients, because they won't have a good cell-mediated immune response. Because of lack of cell-mediated immune response, these patients always will have severe lesions and severe damage. Diagnosis. So in leptomatous leprosy patients, the lesion scrapings, we can do acid fast staining, and we can observe a lot of organisms in these scrapings of these lesions. Whereas in tuberculoid leprosy patient, you can't see any organisms. In tuberculoid leprosy, in punched out biopsy, you can't see any organisms in tuberculoid leprosy patients. And in serological tests, we can identify antibodies against this phenylglycolipid 1, and it is one of the rapid diagnostic tests for leprosy patients. we can do a sensitivity test called Leprumin test. In Leprumin test, tuberculoid leprosy patients always get positive results because they will have a very good cell mediated immune response. So we can see an induration around the injected site, intradermal injected site. They will have a very good Th1 cell response. Th1 cell response, that is cell mediated immune response. Whereas in leprotomatous leprosy patients, the cell mediated immunity is deficit. They won't have good cell mediated immune response. So in leprotomatous leprosy patients, the Leprumin test will be negative because there is no defensive mechanism. So you can't see any induration around the intradermal injected site. So in these patients, you can have Th2 response is very good. That means humoral immune response is very good, whereas cell mediated immune response or Th1 immune response is deficit in leprotomatous leprosy patients. Treatment. For tuberculoid leprosy, we can use dapsone, rifampicin for 6 months together. Dapsone and rifampicin has to be used together for 6 months. Whereas leprotomatous leprosy patients, we have to give clofimazine, rifampicin and dapsone, all these 3 drugs together for 2 years. So prevention is always by early diagnosis and treatment can prevent the major severe damage that occurs in leprosy infections.